Guys, could you hear me? Any one of you ping in the chat window, because that recording is not starting today. I have applied.
Yes, ma'am, audible.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, recording started, ma'am. Hi, guys. Today we are going to look at syntax directed translation. Already we have touched upon, but that is the core theme of the complete fourth unit. You must be in the position to learn for many programming construct syntactic directed translation. So especially syntactic directed translation, in your syllabus point of view, only couple of constructs only given for the discussion, but let us invest some amount of time in understanding this. It is worth spending on syntactic directed translation. Today the topic of discussion is, hope so you will be seeing one notebook. I have written down two problems. One of the problem is 11.11.11, decimal pointer, binary representation to what is a decimal representation is the question. The another question is 11.01, the binary representation to what is a decimal representation is another question. So this is all, these are all the questions you would have come across in your digital logic design or somewhere in the first year, or by this time in your curriculum, these topics would have been covered. Now, let us understand this problem wise. There are two problems only we are going to solve, problem number one or problem number two, whatever vice versa. Then we can go for SDT for this particular method of solving what we are going to, or how we are going to write SDT. So through which definitely you can able to understand how this syntactic directed translation works better. So this is how you can able to understand much better how it is working. Now, what is the role we are going to do is, number one, we are going to solve this problem as a recap. Number two, the same way how as a human we solve, how we are making the compiler to solve this problem or the machine to solve this problem is the aim of discussion today. Let us start with. Now, any one of you can unmute or you can use chat window for the discussion, how you can convert this into decimal representation. If you have any fair idea, you can come forward for the discussion. Either you can use chat window or you can use audio note. How do you transform this binary representation inclusive of decimal pointer? So you have mantissa point and you have exponent point part. So two different portions. So how this representation of the binary value, you can transform it into decimal value. What is the answer? If you know answer also, you can tell me the answer. Then I can explain how that answer has come also. Whatever the method, either you can start with the method or you can come with an answer. So start with this problem first. Although I have written one, this is what we are going to solve now, this problem. Start with this, then we go for this. What is the answer also you can tell. Final answer instead of this question mark, what would be the answer? Or else you can give me the methodology of solving this. How you can solve this binary to decimal conversion given this context. 11.01 binary. Now I want the decimal value. This question mark value I am expecting. What I can write here in this context. Go ahead. You have any answer? Any of you? Yeah, one answer has come. Let me go. 3.25. Very good. So two answers, 515. G2. Thank you for your participation. D4. Yeah, one more methodology explanation you have given. Fine. I will note it down, the answer 3.25. How it has come, let us discuss. Then we can think of SDT. Similarly, this one I will come back and you can give answer. How we need to do is, see, this is the decimal to conversion. We need to multiply this with 2 to the power of 0. Plus we need to multiply with this with 2 to the power of 1. Then 2 to the power of 0 will become 1. 1 into 1, 1, then 2 to the power of 2 is 2, 2 plus 1, finally 2 plus 1 is the answer for this mantissa part. So that, sorry, 2 plus 1, I have mistaken now, okay, 2 plus 1, so the answer would be 3, this part I agree. Next, how we need to work on this part, let us see. Now, dot, you can put dot or you can use plus. Now plus, what is the way you need to calculate is, first you need to convert this portion into decimal value. Numerator should become decimal value. Decimal, this is the numerator. We are going to do one division. Denominator is going to become 2 to the power of, this is one logic. You would have done in different way, I agree, but this is the logic. I'm going to put it into SDT. So that's the reason I myself taken responsibility of explaining. 2 to the power of number of bits. Number of bits given in this problem statement. So let us start now. This is the formula. Please make a note. This is the formula I'm using. One step I would have used a notepad. You may not understand. This is the understanding required for SDT. That is the reason I have come here again. Now let us do 3 plus. What is the decimal value of this? This is 1. All of you would agree, decimal value. 2 to the power of number of bits. How many are there? 2. Then equal to 3 plus 1 divided by 4. What is this 1 divided by 4 then would become? 3 plus 2, 5. So this is how the answer is obtained. I'm not sure you would have used a different method or same method. That's fine. Now tell me what is the answer for this one, this portion. Then I will solve. Same method you can use, ma'am. 11.11. How you have given me the answer 3.25. Similarly, you can give me the answer. Yeah, very good. Thank you, D4. 3.75. Now let us go ahead. So this method of solving, I am going to adapt. This is the value we have seen right now. So it would become 3 only. There is no other choice. So 3. 1 minute. 3. This portion is 3. Plus, how do I do? We need to convert this into decimal equivalent. So decimal equivalent of this 11. Forget about this dot and all. 11. So that is the answer 3. 3 divided by, then number of bits, 2 to the power of 2. This will become 3 plus 3 divided by 4. If you do the calculation or whatever, the division process, you would be ending with 3.75. I think so. These two problems more than enough to understand how this decimal value is converted into binary value converted into decimal value. So now we are going for SDT translation for the same process. The formula behind, you should remember, decimal divided by 2 to the power of number of bits. This is the core logic. Then this part is decimal value. How do you write this part? Decimal value. Finally, what is the SDT highly we require to step into this is this mantissa portion. What you will do right is decimal value. So this decimal value plus what you will do? Decimal divided by 2 to the power of number of bits. Decimal divided by 2 to the power of number of bits. This is the core logic we would be requiring when we develop SDT or when we go for syntactic directed translation. With that note, now I'm going to change the screen for the SDT. Yeah, look at this. Directly if I say this is the answer, some of you may get it, may not get it. So 3 plus 1 divided by 2 to the power of 2, 3.25. Now 111.01, the base 2 is converted into decimal. That is, this decimal value is 15 divided by, the decimal value is 1, number of bits are 2, 2 to the power of 2. Similarly, when we come here only for this portion, how we can do is 3 divided by 2 to the power of 2. then for this we can do 3.75. hope so these many examples sufficient to understand how we are converting this binary to decimal value. Now let us go to the SDT. There are two, this we call it as list of bits. Look at here, list of bits available, 11 bits, sorry, 4 bits are available. Here there are 2 bits, list of bits. Similarly, look at here, list of bits. This only I mean to say L1 and L2. It is going to become same only for our which L. The moment I tell L, no, you may need to differentiate what L I mean to speak. Whether I am speaking about the list of bits before dot, I am speaking about list of bit after dots. For that human understanding perspective only, L1 and L2 internally or semantically it is same. It doesn't mean the two different L's. Okay, when I say L, that the moment I say L, immediately you will be into confusion. Which L I am talking about? That is the reason I am just distinguishing with L1 and L2, nothing more. So L1 and L2. Next, how we can write? First, we need to represent the bit level. We need to start with the grammar. This is a semantic action. We can think little bit later. This semantic action or syntactic directed translation is not the first challenge. Our first challenge, we need to think logically. Through our logical reasoning ability, we need to come out with the grammar first. This is CFG for the entire activity. So what we are going to do is bit. Either it can be 0 or 1. So how you will be writing? B produces 0 or 1 only. So just for semantic action, I have segregated into 2. This is the very, very micro level representation or leaf level representation of the tree. Next, list of bits are going to become either a bit or left recursion. Look at here, left recursion, it doesn't matter. Now when you are developing a grammar for any given problem statement, you can write with left recursion, whatever you want you can do. That is the reason we will be going for left recursion elimination before the parser design. So while writing in the beginning, as a beginner or while developing the CFG by the technical expert, no need to worry about all the consequences. You can write freely, you can think freely. First you can develop the grammar. Later on, while we are going for parser aspects only, we need to convert it into different paradigm. For this, no need of parsing. We are directly converting the CFG into semantic action. So how we are going, let us see. List of bit followed by bit. It is a recursive number of time it will repeat. Finally, a number is constituted with L and L. Temporarily don't consider this L1 and L2. I said earlier L1 and L2 the numbering I have mentioned just for the human interpretation for our discussion. So it is a L dot L only. So this L is made up of several number of bits. This bit is made up of 0 and 1. Hope so you would be understanding this CFG. This is how first we need to design the CFG. Then we need to go for thinking about this syntactic directed translation. This is not our thought discussion, very first step. Look at how the CFG is evolved for this entire problem statement. This is where you need to focus. This CFG portion only. Very much important. How that number is first represented? Conversion only we are going to do. This is for binary representation grammar, not for conversion. Using this binary representation grammar with the support of SDT, we are going to convert it into decimal representation. Now let us look at, we need to count. No, if you look at this conversion time, both are involved. One is involved with the count, another one is involved with the value. You would have noticed I used to say decimal value. One is involved with the count and another one is involved with decimal value. Count is what? Number of bits. This is how we work it. Number of bits. Let us come back here. B count. How many bits are there? 1. P decimal value. How many are there? 1. B count. How many bits are there? 1. Here 1. Decimal value. What is the decimal value of this? 0. Understand this first. Number of bits counting will be 1 because only 1 bit only you are representing. Decimal value is equivalent of its own representation. For 0, we can represent the decimal value 0 only. For 1, we can represent decimal value 1 only. So we have represented. Next, what is the way we are going to do? Here, LHS equal to RHS, that's all. No more action is happening. Whatever is available with B, that it is assigned to L. Nothing more is happening. So that what we can do? Simply, L count equal to B count, L decimal value equal to B decimal value. Hope so. Till this point, you all would be very clear. I'm assuming. If you have any doubt, you can ping me in the chat window or you can unmute. Otherwise, let us move on to here. How we are trying to do? L count equal to, even one more step better we can write. L count equal to 0 semicolon. See, initially, garbage value we don't know. If that question comes, you can initialize with L count equal to 0 also. L count equal to L count plus B count. Every bit, whenever it is analyzed, depending upon the bit level analysis, it will be recursively this counting will happen. L decimal value equal to L decimal value plus B decimal value. Whatever the existing decimal value available plus, see, normally what you will do, 1 into 2 to the power of 1 minute. Cap symbol, 2 to the power of 2 plus 0 into 2 to the power of 1, like that only you will be doing, plus 1 into 2 to the power of 0 plus 1 or 0. This is how you will do the evaluation. Look at here, what is this L decimal value? Might be, if you go from left to right or right to left, in what fashion you are using, depending upon that, the previous term would be available with the decimal value. Rest all would be available with B value. It will be executed recursively. So that is what we have written here. Next, here only ultimate decimal conversion is happening. What we are doing? N dot decimal value, this LHS, is dependent on RHS evaluation. How the RHS evaluation is happening? L1 dot decimal value plus this one, see L1, before the dot operator, whatever the L is available, that decimal value plus L2 dot decimal value divided by 2 to the power of L2 dot count. Number of bits available in this position is going to become your final answer. For your understanding perspective, you can write L1 and L2. After that, you can remove also. It works well. So if you keep also, there is no wrong for the exam point of view. If you remove also, there is no wrong in your exam point of view. So this is how the binary to decimal conversion is happening. Semantic action. This entire segment is called semantic action. Now let us see. This portion is called CFG, context free grammar. This is called semantic action or syntax directed translation. This is what we are discussing right now. Similar manner only I discussed in the previous class, but with your known context, if I start explaining SDT, you would be understanding much better, I thought. That is the reason I have brought this. SDT, even for your general, if at all they are asking SDT, discuss in detail about SDT, you can even articulate this. You can give one or two example. You can give this all explanation and one or two problem solving and the formula how you have used to obtain this binary to decimal conversion. Then you can go for first step, you can write CFG. After writing CFG, put together, you can go for titling like this. This is a portion represents CFG. This portion represents semantic action, syntax directed translation. This is how you need to write. That's it. Hope so you would be understanding. If you have got doubt, you can ping me. Otherwise, I'll just proceed with the next example. Now the next example is STT to generate three address code. This is a given grammar. See, in the beginning itself, I just taken the same grammar. First grammar illustrated with expression evaluation. Second time the same grammar I used, but the context is different. How that context went on? Infix to postfix conversion. There the grammar is retained the same. Where that changes happened? Only in the semantic action writing only changes happened. Now we are using the same grammar again. But what is the activity we are going to carry out here is, we are going to carry out the activity called three address code generation. Just in the previous class only I have introduced what is three address code generation. In a single code, it should not have more than three address references. What is three address references? A is equal to B plus C. This is the exact example for three address. A is one of the address it is referred, B is another address it is referred, C is another address it is referred. So not more than that. But in reality, you may recover this much bigger expression. You may write A is equal to A plus B plus C the whole square into, imagine quadratic equation, minus B plus R minus square root of B square minus 4AC divided by 2A. How much lengthy expression that is? Imagine. This one example is more than enough for me to explain. But internally, quadratic equation is not solved in a shot. Needs to be decomposed into several sequences of instruction. While the decomposition is happening, it consider the concept called three address code representation. At the max, only three references should be considered in the expression evaluation. That is called three address code. Nothing more. Quadruple is what? Again, if you look at quadruple, three address code only. But we are considering operator also in it. Argument 1, argument 2, operation or operator and result. These are all the four columns. In any order you can write. That is not at all an issue. You can start with result also, operator also, operand 1, operand 2. Or you can write like this. Operand 1, operator, operand 2, result. Or argument 1, operator, argument 2, result. In any order you can write. That is called quadruples. Whatever the representation you use, ultimately only three addresses are considered. That you should remember all the time. Three address locations or memory locations. That memory can be symbol table or RAM memory, we no need to worry. Somehow the memory or register also. Register is also one type of memory only, I said. Flip-flops. It has the fastest access memory. In the last class itself, I mentioned what are all the possible memories available. Also, I have given in the previous session. So register is also a memory, fast accessing memory. That only memory can communicate with CPU. So what we are referring, it doesn't matter. Whether you refer symbol table or RAM memory or you are referring register, it doesn't matter at all. But finally, in the micro instruction level, we need to emphasize to the compiler to refer only three references, three times of fetching or referring. That simple example is A is equal to B plus C. That's all. Now we are going for SDT to generating three address code. First, you should not look at this portion. You need to look at only CFG. Once if you understand CFG, then you can focus on SDT. Okay. Before the line, give your attention, please focus. And later on, we can think of anything else. So right now, you no need to worry about before, after this line. Now, consider ID, T produces T star F, RF, then E produces E plus T, RT. Look at here, this one never you need to worry. Why this E1, T1 are given is, which T I mean to say? See, there are three places T's are available. So which T I mean to refer? Which E I mean to refer? Left hand E or right hand E? If I say E1, naturally your eyes and brain interprets I'm talking about right hand side, I'm not at all bothered about left hand side. If I mention T1, naturally your eyes and brain copes up with this, not this. So that is the reason E1, T1. Don't worry all the time why that E1 has come, T1 has come. Finally, what we are going to do is ID equal to some expression. This expression consists of addition operation, multiplication operation. So the repetitive of addition and multiplication only it is considered. These two operations are carried out with the support of ID. At the end of all the expression, that evaluated expression or that entire expression is given to the resultant variable that is called ID. This is the starting statement. Always the evaluation will work in the order bottom to top so that I can give arrow also. So this is the arrow. It grows from bottom to top. Let us now look into three address code. Expression we are aiming at this expression. So when we look at this expression, what is the thing we need to consider? So f place equal to id.name. ID is given by the user. You will be mentioning a is equal to b plus c. So that a is equal to b plus c, that ID stands for b. So what is a b given by the user? Compiler doesn't know. So that name given by the user, you may give number one also, you may give argument one, you may give anything with related to if it is a square of if your area of finding square, you may give a side and height and width, you may give. So that name, whatever the identifier name the programmer mentioned, that you are giving to the reference called f.place. In the next production, f.place you are initializing to t.place. In the next production, what you are going to do, you are generating a temporary variable. T.place is temporary place is equal to t.place into f.place. Look at here, t.place is generated with new temp. You are creating new temporary variable here. This focus on this portion. So the t.place is created with a new function called new temp. New temporary variable you are creating. That temporary variable is generated with this compute, with this code, t1.place into f.place. This is not evaluation, three address code generation. So that generate only we need to write, not computation, evaluation. We are not evaluating. We are generating three address code. So that three address code. Look at here. E.place equal to t.place. It's a simple assignment. So always this is easier. Look at here. When it comes e.place, we need to create a new temporary variable that is named as e.place. That variable can be, that new temporary variable can be generated internally. That could be anything, r1, t1, x1, y1, anything. But that is referred as in externally e.place. Now we are generating the code after this temporary variable generation. e.place is equal to e.place plus t.place. It is not e1, e.place only. Whenever I mean to talk about E, which side I mean to say, for that identity E1 is given. Next, generating the code with this assignment statement, id.name equal to whatever available in the E.place finally given to ID. See, look at S, E. One more also we need to write, 1 minute. S, E, this E can be, yeah, correct, because no T is given. E or T is given, I need to change. ID equal to only E. This E is obtained either from F or T, whatever the method. E is ultimate way to communicate with ID so that this perfect, this STT is perfect. So no more, thing need to be considered. If at all I'm including T star, one more step also I can include. T produces T star F. Here itself I can include one more also. How I can include? Here R. And I can include one more step. It is called T divided by F. that then based on the priority, then here I can include one more step. Here always star and division will have equal priority, so that suits. Here if I wish, instead of this simple T or along with the T also, I can include one more operation E minus T as well. Whenever I am including E minus T, then I need to write a syntactic directed translation for this as well. So this is the two places I can write like this. Now how can I write this? One minute. T is equal T produces T division. Yeah, correct only. So this already T is available. Let us write three address code so that you will understand much more. Newly I'm including, assuming that I'm changing the grammar. If I change the grammar, this is called T produces T plus F. Now how can I write SDT for this? This is capital T. I need to write, first I need to generate a temporary variable t dot place, this one t dot place, first I need to create. Now new temp, one temporary variable you are creating. You can write temporary variable also, temp variable, it's all our choice only. We are creating new temporary variable. After the creation of new temporary variable, you need to go for generating T dot place is a place equal to, how you will be doing generation of generate, you will be generating T dot place divided by F dot place. That's all. This is the ultimate SDT code for newly introduced production. Now how we can do for this, let us see. So here this production E produces E minus T. Similarly, I need to first create a temporary variable. E dot place is equal to new temporary variable underscore variable, new variable I need to generate. That temporary variable E dot place is generated with E dot place minus T dot place. That's all. This is the SDT for newly included productions. It is possible we can include this production here. See, R of this R I can keep here. TRF R T divided by F R F. So that newly introduced production I need to include here. Altogether I can rewrite this entirety. This is how SDT works. The same grammar more or less we are discussing from the beginning. For the same grammar, so far now three SDT we have discussed. Number one, we discussed for expression evaluation. Number two, we have discussed for infix to postfix expression. Number three, we are discussing it for generating three address code. So these are all the three variants we have discussed with the almost same grammar in terms of SDT. And today we discussed how the SDT can be written for this binary to decimal conversion. With that, let me conclude today. We can continue in the next session.